So, in OpenStudio 0.11, a new application called the Parametric Analysis Tool is being introduced, and that's what you're seeing here. The purpose of this is to run parametric analysis on models you made in OpenStudio, either in the SketchUp plugin or the OpenStudio application. And that's accomplished through applying energy conservation measures, which, if you're familiar with user scripts in OpenStudio, these are more formalized versions of those that have reporting and an interface in the GUI to display those arguments. So it allows users to extend the interface for any types of conservation measures that they might want to apply or create. So you see a splash screen when you first launch this, and I'm going to create a new project. You either need to make a new project or open one to kind of get into the main interface. And so I'll name this one. And then I'll browse where I would like it to be. Now, this is the first video, but I'll have three videos that go through the basic workflow in PAT, and then a fourth video that goes into editing or creating your own measures. So once it launches, if you're familiar with the standalone OpenStudio application, this should look familiar. We have a library section on the right, and then we have some tabs at the left that walk you through the workflow. The first tab is a tab for creating or organizing measures for your project and setting arguments. The next tab will let you create design alternatives based on those measures. So you'll take one or more measures and connect them together to create the design alternative. Then we'll run the simulations, and then you'll look at the results all within this application. So this first video is just going to add some measures, and then we'll jump into the next video. So at the right, we have BCL measures and my measures. So I'm going to use the BCL measures for now. And they're categorized in a taxonomy that breaks them down on what part of the building you're going to change. So to start with, I'm going to go to envelope and then fenestration, and I'm going to set the window to wall ratio. And so this is a measure here, and when I drag it in, I create an instance of that. And so I can drop in three or four or as many as you want instances. And you'll notice this is called a group. I'll explain the groups in a minute, but what I'm going to do here is I can change this one to maybe, we'll leave that at 0.4 here, and if I want to, I can change the name. They're all going to be south for my case, so I'm not going to put south in the description. I'm just going to put something that's unique. And again, that's optional. You don't have to change that. Actually, let's go down the other way. Let's go to 0.3 and then 0.2. Oops, change that. Okay, and we'll leave the sill height the same on all those. So the idea of a design group is that when you go to the making your measures, you'll have one measure from each design group. You could skip some design groups altogether, but you wouldn't take two measures from the same design group and put them in the same alternative. That'll make more sense when we get to the next tab. So what I want to do next while we're in the envelope section is go and put on an overhang. And we'll just make a new group for this. And I'll just make two of those. Their default is 0.5, and so we'll leave that alone. And then maybe I'll put this one to 1. And then we'll make one more group. Let's change our lighting. So when I get into lighting, I can change either the lighting itself or the controls. And so one option is to lower the lighting by percentage as opposed to setting a specific lighting power density. So I'm going to drag that to its own group here. It defaults to 30%, and it's set for the entire building. You can apply it to a specific space type, although this brings up a good point. I haven't loaded a seat model. So I'm going to go click here and browse. You can do this at the beginning, but you can also do this after you've set up some measures. But you want to do it before you get to your design alternatives. And so that'll take a second to load in because it's building up the measure arguments based on the content in the model itself. Okay, so now that that's done, if I look back at this last one here, instead of entire building, I also have the space types that are used in there. And I'm going to leave it to entire building for now. And then let's go and change the nighttime setback on a specific types of lighting. So I'll make a new group for that. Now you'll notice there's this warning here. That's an indication that you're either missing an argument or that the argument has an invalid value. So when I click on that, in this case, it's looking for a definition from the project, and so that has to be chosen once you've loaded the seed model. And so the lighting I'm using is actually the 1980 to 2004. Let's do our guest room lighting. So this has a fractional value for nighttime, and then you can define what is nighttime, and then you can choose whether it's just weekday or weekend, or Saturday and Sunday, rather. Now, I'm going to actually move this particular measure group up, and you can see I can do that with the arrow. When I go to design alternatives, they'll be applied in the order that you see the groups here, and I want to apply the change to the schedule before I reduce the percentages, and the reason for that is that sometimes we'll clone the object, and I want to make sure that things get picked up correctly, so that's why I'm changing the order there. So really, that's all I'm going to do here. We do have some IDF measures that can be applied to the IDF file once you've converted it at runtime from an OSM to an IDF, but I'm not going to run any of those now, but they are available, and that allows you access to elements in Energy Plus that may not directly be supported in OpenStudio. So anyway, we'll go to this next tab here and pick it up on the next video.